This video is about astrophysics. Astrophysics is the branch of astronomy that deals with the nature of cosmic objects. Astrophysics relates to the stars, planets, and everything in between. It is about how they form, function, and what they are made of. The first type of star here, the Red Dwarf Star, is also the most common star in the universe. These stars are small and live for a very long time. Some red dwarfs can live for up to 10 trillion years. There are two main reasons these stars live for so long. One, since they are very small, they are under far less pressure from gravity. Two, inside their mass, they have large currents which transport the various gases, mainly hydrogen, across their entire star from the outside to the very center. They effectively make sure that these stars use up all of their fuel before dying. The second type of star here, the Yellow Dwarf Star, is also the star that we orbit. These stars are mid-sized stars that generally live for around 10 billion years. When a Yellow Dwarf Star runs out of its main source of fuel, hydrogen, it begins to expand. When it expands, it grows to many times its size and becomes what is known as a red giant. A red giant star is very large and glows red. The temperature of the star's surface decreases, but since the star itself is now larger, the total temperature increases. This expansion will allow it to begin merging and fusing helium, which effectively turns helium into its new source of fuel. Eventually, once it exhausts all of its fuel, it sheds its outer layers. It ejects away its outer layers into what is known as a planetary nebula. A planetary nebula is a disk of gas that surrounds a red giant star that has died. At the center of a planetary nebula, there will be what is known as a white dwarf. A white dwarf is the remains of a yellow dwarf star. It's simply the matter that has not been ejected into space. The white dwarf will glow white hot and will slowly fade away until it becomes a black dwarf, which is simply the white dwarf without any of the heat. The third type of star is a blue giant star. Blue giants are the largest and hottest stars in the universe. They also have the shortest lives. They live for only about 100 million years on average because their extremely large size puts a very large amount of pressure from gravity onto them. This forces them to use up their fuel very fast. When a blue giant star uses up its hydrogen, its main source of fuel, it begins to collapse inward. When that happens, the collapse causes the core of the star, where nuclear fusion and therefore the energy generation takes place, to increase in temperature. This increase in temperature will then allow for the star to begin fusing heavier elements like helium and everything that comes after that. These new elements will be fused faster and faster. They'll be fused faster than the element before them. So helium will be fused faster than hydrogen. And anything that comes after that will be fused even faster and so on until it gets to iron. When it gets to iron, it can no longer do anything because iron does not produce energy when it is fused and compressed. Here, the star begins to collapse one last time. The outer layers of the star fall into the core and then suddenly bounce off it in a massive explosion in what is called a supernova explosion. These are the largest explosions in some of the largest events in the universe. They can outshine entire galaxies. Some supernovas can produce what is called a gamma ray burst. A gamma ray burst is a stream of highly charged particles that shoot out of a star. These bursts are extremely powerful, and if one were to hit Earth, it would destroy the ozone layer and irradiate and kill much of the planet. A neutron star is one of the byproducts that could occur from the death of a large blue giant star. If the core is below a certain mass, then during the supernova, the core will collapse, but will not collapse indefinitely. It will not continue collapsing. Eventually, it will stop and form an object that is made of extremely dense core matter. All the atoms and different protons and electrons of the atoms are squeezed into neutrons. That's why it's called a neutron star. A neutron star, because it holds the mass of a star's core, but is much smaller, it's about as small as a city, it is extremely dense. A traditional atom is mostly empty space. However, in a neutron star, all the empty space is filled with neutrons. There is no empty space at all. It's all completely clogged. This makes the matter of neutron stars extremely heavy. One teaspoon weighs billions of tons. A black hole is the most extreme remain of a dead blue giant star. If a star's core is 3 times more massive than our sun, it will continue collapsing beyond even a neutron star. Eventually, it gets to a point where the density of the core is infinite, and that is called the singularity. A black hole has infinitely strong gravity beyond a certain point. This gravity is so strong that beyond what is known as the event horizon, light cannot escape it. That is why we call it a black hole, because even the light is dragged in. We cannot see what happens inside. At a certain area, however, light actually begins to orbit the black hole the same way that a planet would orbit a star. Also, the time close to a black hole slows down due to the immense gravity. There are two types of black holes: stellar mass black holes, which form from large stars dying, and supermassive black holes, which are believed to form from multiple different stellar mass black holes colliding and merging. Supermassive black holes are often found in the center of galaxies. The last part is about planets. Planets are simply formed from the matter that is not used up by the star. There are many different types of planets. Rocky planets like Earth, gas giants like Jupiter and Saturn, ice giants like Uranus and Neptune, Earth-like planets, which are planets that have similar atmospheres to Earth. We have not observed any Earth-like planets yet, but they may exist. Carbon planets, a type of possible planet made in a solar system that has more carbon than it has oxygen. This is thought to be possible near the center of the galaxy. Desert planets like Mars that have very little or no water on the surface. Ice planets. Ocean planets, which is a type of planet that has its entire surface covered in water. These are some examples of the classifications used for planets. In our own solar system, there are a few different types of planets. First, there is Mercury, Venus, and Earth and Mars, which are rocky planets. Mars is also considered to be a desert planet. There are gas giants, Jupiter and Saturn, and Uranus and Neptune being ice giants. Pluto was at one point considered to be an ice planet until it was demoted to the status of a dwarf planet. However, there are actually extrasolar planets, or planets that orbit other stars, that are even more strange than the ones that we have here. For example, there is a type of planet called a hot Jupiter. A hot Jupiter is simply a gas giant that orbits very close to its star, closer than Mercury does to our star. Hot Jupiters take mere days to orbit their star, and as a result of this, their atmospheres are hotter than that of any other planet. There's another type of planet called a Chthonian planet, which is simply a hot Jupiter which has had its entire atmosphere blown off, leaving only the solid core. Most of these planets are hostile to life. However, our telescopes have detected many planets that orbit in what is known as the Goldilocks zone of a star. This is simply the zone that of a star's orbit where it is not hot enough to cause water to evaporate, but is not cold enough to cause water to freeze over. Our Earth happens to orbit exactly in the middle. And there are many other planets that have been found in this situation. However, we have yet to find a good study of their atmospheres, and although we have found ideas of what kind of gases those planets can hold, it's still difficult to confirm right now. However, with the launch of the James Webb Space Telescope in 2021, we should be able to find better evidence of what an extrasolar planet's atmosphere will be like. And one of the main goals of the James Webb Telescope is to analyze what these planets are like and if life can exist on them. Thank you for watching this video. I hope you learned some things about what stars, planets, and other astronomical objects are like. And I will see you in the next video.